This song is for those that know without a doubt in their mind, I made it out all right.
Romans 8, verse 5 to 6. Please on this wise, if you don't have a Bible, it's there on your screen. For those who are according to the flesh set their minds on the things of the flesh. But those who are according to the Spirit, or after the Spirit, the things of the Spirit. For the mind set on the flesh, am I reading this right? Is death. But the mind set on the Spirit is both life and peace. Amen. Amen. On your way to your seat, just hit your neighbor and tell them, reset your mind.
Reset your mind.
Amen. You may be seated in the presence of a holy and wise God. Rick Norton said it like this. Rick Norton says, every sunset is an opportunity to reset. You say that with me,
every sunset
is an opportunity to reset.
In life, brothers and sisters, as long as God has graced me to live, I have found out it always seems like there's never a right time to reset your mind.
Amen.
If we could put off resetting our mind till tomorrow, we would. But many times, brothers and sisters, we must recognize that the time to reset our mind is now. The importance of resetting the mind oftentimes is often detected when we have a problem that we cannot fix. How many of you would never change or do anything different as long as you don't have a problem? Y'all ain't gonna say amen. But in life, how many know, is full of problems. That's why Job declared that man is of a few days old. And all of those days are full of trouble. Can I tell you this? You don't have to go looking for trouble. Trouble has a way, y'all ain't gonna help me here, of come looking for you. And many times it's not till we have problems that we recognize that we need to change our eternal thinking. Lactose intolerant people, brothers and sisters, I found something about people who have lactose intolerance to milk. It's what is called an allergic reaction to milk. The problem is a condition that lies not in the milk, but in the biochemical makeup of a person. In other words, brothers and sisters, the flaw is not in the milk, it's in you. Oh, no glory, y'all not gonna help me here. The milk only reveals the fact. Watch this, but it does not reveal the cause of it. Paul is suggesting in our text, brothers and sisters, that the law of God is perfect in every detail. Nothing is wrong with the word of God. There's just something wrong with us.
Amen.
Oh, I wish I had help here.
Amen.
The mind of mankind, brothers and sisters, is somewhat like a computer. You ever want to see a computer? A computer is almost like the structure of a man's mind. It holds storage data. It processes information. And it does everything, brothers and sisters, to fight off viruses and infections. But how many know over time, just like a computer, your mind can receive, watch this, brain overload. There's somebody here this morning, as beautiful as you look, you're dealing with worry. You're dealing with stress. Hallelujah. How many know that you can have something going on in your heart and it can affect your mind? Some of us, brothers and sisters, are just suffering, Sam, from just plain wear and tear. Life has a way of doing that. And let's not even talk about the age factor. Some of you have a good conscience and to be in service and hear the word, but your medicine go working on you. You're drifting. You listen to the word, all of a sudden slob run down your face. Your eyes are closed. Y'all got quiet now. See, age has a way has a way of playing on the mind as well. A new computer does not process the same way old computers do. As we age, brothers and sisters, then it becomes a requirement that you must, like you and I, we must practice maintenance that has to be done both often and with intent. Do I have any old people in here over 50? That sometimes what you have to do is you have to leave your shoes in the same place. And y'all ain't gonna say amen. If you don't put that toothbrush back up when you get through with it, y'all got quiet. If you don't put your pocketbook beside the couch, like you, y'all, I'm gonna throw the mic if y'all don't say amen. You have to do certain things when you get older to put stuff where it is. Otherwise, you'll forget, y'all. Amen. Y'all got quiet there. A mother one day, she was trying to look for her teeth. Y'all ain't gonna say amen. She couldn't find her teeth. She was all over the house, and the car was coming. She's like, Lord, no, I can't go to this funeral without my teeth. And all of a sudden, she looked, and her daughter come to the house. She said, baby, she said, I can't go to that funeral. She said, Mama, why you can't go? She said, baby, I can't find my teeth. She said, where were you at last? She said, last thing I remember, I was in there trying to find something in the pantry. Well, what she did is, y'all ain't gonna say, man, she went in the pantry and put her teeth in the cereal box after she pulled the cereal. Y'all got quiet. Because see, as you age, y'all ain't gonna say amen. You age, you have the propensity not to process like you did when you was young. Ain't nobody gonna testify to that. So brothers and sisters, make this notation. Then therefore, as it relates to your mind, you gotta know the difference between rebooting and resetting. Y'all get me in this house. Now to reboot simply means to disconnect or discontinue power to your processing system. It does not change anything, watch this, about the computer. It just disconnects you for a period of time from the power. It's still the same computer. It's just resting from its activities for a period of time. In other words, let me sum it up like this. You're just taking a break. Now, is there anyone in here in life you find that your life just needs a break? I made a vow in 2020, and hopefully this will help somebody who lives a life that's hectic and busy. I have made a vow in 2020, I'm going to build in weekly breaks. Because I believe without healthy breaks in your life, wait for it, you just might break. And brothers and sisters, life is not to be out-muscled, it's to be managed. If I just attack it, if I just keep going at it. How many know you can't take on life? Life has took on everybody and still won. Amen. Y'all ain't gonna say amen. I've been guilty of it, Brother Rich. Why don't you just take a break and pick it up tomorrow? No, I need to finish this tonight. Got to finish this tonight. Amen. All of a sudden, you finish it tonight, and you're slow getting up the next day. You're tired, need to put down 4 cups of coffee just to make it through tomorrow. Because watch this, you didn't calculate that you only have sufficient energy to attack the sufficiency of the day. Life is not to be out-muscled, brothers and sisters. It's to be managed. So brothers and sisters, I want you to know that many times on my laptop, I tell you, I get all the work out of that laptop. Lord Jesus, I get it out of it. And I was turned the laptop on a few days ago, Sister Scott. What happened was I went to get some coffee and I came back and it was still booting. And I was sitting there saying, now, what in the world is this wrong with this computer? I went to get some coffee. I came back, Deacon Scott, and it was still boot. Y'all ain't gonna say amen. Lean over to your neighbor and say, did you catch it? Tell them you can be trying to function and be too tired to go. And just cause you crossed over from 2019 to 2020 don't mean you still got energy. Y'all got quiet. Some of you thought when you crossed over to a new year, you was gonna get this rush of energy like you drunk some Mountain Dew, and y'all help me here, and you dragging out the bed like a drunk man and a drunk woman. Say, oh Lord, I got to go to work. Oh Lord, I got to. You know why? Because your system needs a rebooting. And brothers and sisters, I found out that laptop just kept spinning and spinning and spinning. And I had to unplug it. Y'all ain't gonna say amen. And this is why anyone who has anybody in your life, scoot up close, that helps you have at least 30 minutes to reboot, you ought to give God praise for it. If you got a cousin that come pick up your trifling kids, y'all got quiet, just to let you take a nap, you ought to call them and tell them thank you for helping me reboot. Ooh, we got quiet in here. If you got a mother or a father that takes your trifling toddlers, y'all got quiet, and keep them for any period of time, you ought to take them out the Red Lobster and give them some Caucasian fondue.
Y'all got quiet. I'm trying to help somebody here. Brothers and sisters, you ought to give God praise because, watch this, life sometimes is too much. And some of us have to recognize that when you try to do life on your own, it gets twice as hard. Repeat after me, everybody needs somebody. And brothers and sisters, on the other hand, not only do you, some of you in here who need to reboot, but some of y'all need to reset. Now let me tell you the difference between resetting a computer versus rebooting a computer. When you reset a computer, you erase everything and restore it back to the day you purchased it. It's called, brothers and sisters, some of you here in January, you need a clean slate. Oh, y'all making this hard. This is a mentality that everything in your life, when you recognize this, is out of balance. Just because you press your way to church and sit in here and look at we're wonderful today, don't mean that your life is not out of balance. You can be trying to do good and your life be out of balance. Before the decisions that you made, before the relationship, somebody holler, reset. Before you got into debt on something that you thought you needed, but it's driving you crazy. Before the new this and before the new that. It's a moment in your life when you reset, when you took on something, watch this, that over time started wearing you out. Do I have any witnesses out there that say there are some people you took on in your life that will wear you out? Y'all got quiet. That fancy car you walking around with that's red and you, y'all ain't gonna say amen. And every time that don't come, you have a tantrum in the living room because over time, when you thought it was a good thing, it started to wear you out. And lately, brothers and sisters, if you have been functioning and living life, Sister Wanda, with regret, it could be you need to be reset.
That's right.
It makes you sad because, brothers and sisters, deep down within, you know you need to get back to your happy place. Have any witnesses out there that evaluated your life over the last several weeks and said, Lord, I just want to get back to my happy place? Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lamb of God. He's wonderful and worthy to be praised. That place, when you get to the place of reset, brothers and sisters, is the place where you was the most happiest.
Yeah.
It's a place where nothing bothers you. You know when you need to be reset, and that's when folks say something.
Yeah.
They say something to you. Say, if you say one more thing, I'm going to knock the teeth out of your mouth.
See, yes.
That's when you got an attitude. And watch this. It's everybody's fault but yours. Uh-oh, my fault. When people around you, they tolerate you because they already know you are a pain in the butt, and they know you got a button on the back of your head that needs to be reset. Lean over, lay your hand gently on your neighbor. Say, neighbor, before the service is over, I'm going to hit your reset button. That's when you was happy, you was nice. That's when you treat your friends real good. That's when you look at your enemies and say, you're not going to bother me. I'm praying for you. See, that's when you at a happy place. And brothers and sisters, I want you to know, let me do this. Can I get about 10 people just throw up both your hands and say, Lord, reset me.
Lord, reset me.
Yeah, that's what the Lord's going to do with you.
Amen.
He's going to reset you. He's going to take them cuss words back. Yeah, Oh, that quiet. Right? He gonna slap you with the holy hush. Right? Right? Amen. He gonna make you look at people just say, you know what? I ain't gonna even bother with you. I'm praying for you. Amen. See, anybody used to be in that place and know that sometime in life stuff can happen to you and people think that you mean, you not mean, you just fed up, you just overwhelmed, you just overloaded. I'm coming to get y'all, I feel the anointing. Some of y'all are the sweetest things since sliced bread. But when life is heavy, when finances are tough,
when you're going through stuff, when people mistreat you, when people don't misunderstand you, it puts your guard up. Y'all ain't gonna say amen. Now you say stuff to get, I'm gonna get you off of me. Y'all help me here. And I want to help somebody today to let you know that this Sunday, this new year, God's getting ready to hit your reset button. You're going back to how you used to love. You're going back to how you used to treat people nice. You're going back to being quiet, slow to speak, and quick to listen. Do I have any witnesses to say, I've gotten so far away from that, I don't even know what that feels like anymore? But I've been five people jump up on your feet and say, Lord, reset me.
Reset me. Reset me. That I'm not at the mall. Searching for stuff. Trying to put it in my buggy in my car when I don't have no inner peace. Lord, reset me. Reset me till in my relationships I understand my place and where I'm supposed to be. Reset me. Reset my attitude when I come to the church. Reset me. Reset my desire in me seeking after you and trying to come after your promises. Lord, reset me. Yeah. You are having the witnesses out there waving their hand and say, I need a resetting. I need a resetting. So there are two types of people this morning as I keep trying to hurry to my clothes. Yeah. There are two different kinds of people. There are people in here who need to be rebooted. And then, yes, there are people, yes, that need to be reset. Now, if you think that your life is doing okay, but you just can stand a break, you can just stand some things just to be on pause so you can gain strength, raise your hand. That means you need to be rebooted. But some of you that have been playing with a hand of spades and you can't never win. Y'all ain't gonna say amen. Everything in life is difficult for you. Everything you try, you fail. I want to let you know you need to be reset. In life, seems like it's together. Now, for those who need to be rebooted, write these two things. You need a time to disconnect. And to reboot, you also need a time to diagnose. To disconnect, brothers and sisters, means to break the connection of or between, unhook or uncouple. Scoot up close. This may be a thing unto you that even when you're married, you need to disconnect. Okay. Let me take the long way around. As much as y'all love each other, it does not make it exempt y'all get on each other's nerves. And the second reason that you need to disconnect is from this simple point. Nobody in your... And some of you are frustrated in your relationship because you think they ought to be 10 times better to you and they not. And the issue is this, brothers and sisters. You need to disconnect because you're, watch this, you out of balance. Because you have failed that the only one that has never changed, the only one that doesn't change yesterday, today, and forevermore is the Lord. Lean over and lay your hand on your neighbor and say, neighbor, I know you won't tell me, but I know I'm sitting next to somebody crazy. I keep talking and say, if you don't take your medicine, comb your hair, put your teeth in, and come on, tell them, and put in your good eyes, you have a tendency to cut up sometime. Everybody say disconnect. 1 Corinthians 7:5 says it like this: marriage is not only you married as married couples, but if you can see it in a spiritual light, it's your company. Sometimes you marry to your business. Sometimes you marry to fraternities and sororities. You marry to groups. These are my boys. You got to see them every day? You know, I got to be with them every day. You're a fool. Y'all ain't going to say amen. You need to disconnect. Y'all ain't going to say amen. They got this movie out with this black woman, this white man. He was KKK and she was just a good soul sister. Y'all ain't say amen. When his daughter was sick and in the hospital, could nobody help him except the black woman to help him. He didn't want the black woman to bother his kid because she was black. But he took care of that. She took care of that boy. They got him switched over to a new room and saw his heart change. I ain't gonna say amen.
When he went back to the KKK boys who told him to hate black folks, he said, I would love to hate black folks, but I got a problem. One of them helped my daughter. Y'all, see, when you reboot, it helps you to re-diagnose who you really are. Can I tell you, if you were rebooted in life, you wouldn't hate some folks you think you hate. Oh, it's quiet in here. But you got to learn how to disconnect. 1 Corinthians 7:5 says, do not deprive each other of sexual relations unless you both agree. Now scoot up close, because when I slow down, that means I'm teaching. Now, we in a relationship, you can't tell me I can't have none. Unless we agree. I'm in the Bible. 1 Corinthians 7. Yes, you wrote it down right. 1 Corinthians 7:5. I don't feel like it. And do not deprive each other of sexual relations unless you both agree to refrain from sexual intimacy. And then Paul said it like this: if you do decide not to give him it, do it for a limited time. Y'all got quiet. He said the only reason y'all shouldn't be intimate is unless you in prayer and fast. Touch your neighbor and say, the song just ain't, Lord, I'm available to you. Come on, tell them that. Tell them, you tell your boo, I'm available for you. Only for a time of prayer. Only for a time of prayer. In other words, he's saying this: if you're going to cheat on him or her, cheat on them with me. If you're going to substitute their time out, substitute their time for me. Not only do you have to disconnect, brothers and sisters, but it gives you time to diagnose. This is when you find out that sometime when you got an attitude with other folks, your real problem is you. Now, I know this is hard, my brother Bell. This is hard because many times it's always somebody else's fault. Ain't nothing ever wrong with you. But brothers and sisters, it gives you a time to say, oh Lord, I found out when I looked in the mirror who the problem was. I'm overloaded, I'm tired, and I need to unplug. Brothers and sisters, not only do we need to reboot, we need to reset. We need to reset. Reset means to do things differently, to realign. After recognizing something is working wrong. How many will admit today that there's some areas of your life that don't work quite right? Watch this. You can't reset if you don't first recognize. If you keep going around saying, I ain't got no problems, then you're going to stay with that problem. Say it with me. Recognize and then reset. I recognize that laptop kept spinning, mother folder, it just kept spinning. I'm doing this. Come on. I gotta send this email just sitting there spinning. Lord Jesus, come on. And then all of a sudden I had to unplug. I had to unplug from the source. Let me ask you this. Do some of you got a source feeding you that's unhealthy? And every time you look in your life, you spinning out of control. It ain't you sometimes, it's the power source that you let feed you. Amen. Now don't put all the blame on someone else, because watch this, brothers and sisters. Ephesians 4:23 says it on his wise, that in any manner we all need renewal.
That's right.
Repeat after me, I need to be renewed. Where does renewal take place? He tells us in Ephesians
Ephesians 4:23, he said, in the spirit of thy mind. Brothers and sisters, your spirit is housed in your mind. If you got a bad spirit, you got a bad mind. You got an upset spirit, you got an upset mind. You got an upset, you got a nasty spirit, Lord Jesus. You got a nasty mind. This is why, brothers and sisters, I love what happened here on Watch Night Service. I believe God resets your spirit. I love it. I heard the testimonies from some of the saints, how they came through the car wash. Praise the Lord. And God kept moving upon the saints, and the presence of God gave you refreshing in your spirit. Can I tell you, stop wanting to fix a church. Ask God for a spiritual refreshing every time you come. Brothers and sisters, it's something about resetting your spirit. To reset your spirit, can I ask you a question? Do you take time to recognize when something is not working properly in your life? Do you recognize it? Brothers and sisters, you must understand that until you recognize it, you have to face it. If you don't face it, you could just be existing with the same attitude. And the same situations keep getting the best of you because you won't change. Verse 24 says it like this: put on the new self. Do you know there are two parts to you? It's you, but then it's the one that God died for. That's called the new man. And many of us live in the old man so much, we don't ever allow the new man to take his place. Do I have any witnesses here, brothers and sisters? I am praying for you that over the next several days, when we get ready to take on the fast, that God's going to do something in your new man.
Amen.
God's going to do something in your new man. Fast. What that mean, Pastor? Well, no food. Only water. 3 days. And then 21 days on the Daniel fast. That's no meat, no sodas, no cake. Ooh, you got quiet. I'm hearing y'all die now because I'm trying to get the new man out of there. All right? No coffee, no pig's feet, no skins, no. Matter of fact, lay your hand on your neighbor and just say the answer is no. Go ahead and tell them. Tell them when the icebox call you, tell them no. When your friends call you, take you to rest. I'm telling you, when you on the fast, folks call you out of the blue. Y'all gonna say amen. Amen. You gonna smell hamburgers at the stop sign when the window is half cracked. Y'all ain't gonna say amen. But tell your neighbor, I'm getting ready to renew my inner man. Well, I didn't bore you long enough, brothers and sisters, in our text. Paul is advising the church at Rome that the way that you live your life is based on the things that you know. Some of you can only live according to what you know. He says that our minds either are infected by the way of what we know, or they enforce what we should do right. Y'all see that? Phronema sarcos means the lust of the flesh. Paul is asking, does your mind work for God, or does your mind work against God? Do you run away from trouble, or do you succumb to it? The mind of the flesh is to live a life of gratification. If it don't do anything for me, I don't want any parts of it. Looking for things that make you happy. Looking for things that affect your emotions. Looking for things that motivate your motives, and your selfishness is always selfish, and you know yourself. The answer is simple in the text. If you look at this key word in the text, it says this: what are you chasing? Because whatever you chasing is going to get in you. Y'all help me through here. Say it with me: whatever I'm chasing is going to get in my mind. If you are after flesh, he said, you're going to be full of lust as a dog is fleas. If your appetite is out of control, if it's difficult for you to do the things of the spirit, brothers and sisters, when I talk to new converts and things, I try to encourage them, you know, Pastor, it's hard to live this life. Well, it's live this life because it's hard to live this life chasing after another life. Oh, y'all hear me here. Everything that you want to do for God will end up being a fight for you. I've been there. I know that's how it rolls. It's a fight for you to be faithful. It's a fight for you. You're looking for an escape goal. You're looking for somebody to upset you so you can quit. You're looking for every opportunity in life to cause you to stop doing the God kind of thing. But the devil is a liar. I said the devil is a liar. Brothers and sisters, Paul says, if this is what controls you, then this is what's going to be on your mind. Y'all ain't going to say amen to that. You can't chase Danny, come on, and chase the divine at the same time. Whatever you're chasing, you're going to get full of. That's why sometimes people already know who you've been hanging around. When you're hanging around folks, you take on their spirit. You take on their nature. You start dressing like them. You cut your hair like them. You do what they do because that's what they got in your spirit. And after a while, that's what you chase. Oh, y'all not gonna say amen. But when Jesus died on Calvary, he gave us the opportunity to have a new mind. This is why the Bible declares that the place that Jesus died isn't just called Calvary. But Calvary in the Hebrew is called Golgotha. Golgotha in Aramaic is called the place of the skulls. I wish somebody help me through here. Matthew 27 and 33 calls it, and they went out of that place called Golgotha, which means the place of the skull. God did not die so you could be rich. God did not allow Jesus to die so you can have overflow. He died to get your mind right. Y'all ain't gonna say amen. He died so you can have a fight that when you're going through what you're going through, you don't have to cuss and be nasty and mistreat people when you're going through, but you can hold your peace and let the Lord fight your battle because you recognize that this mind, Philippians 2 and 5, oh my God, that was in Christ Jesus is also in me. I declare in this place, some of you are getting ready to have a revisitation of the resetting of your mind. I prophesy in this house that the pridefulness that you got right now, God's getting ready to restore you to a humble mind. God's getting ready to cause you to just want to do right again. Now I know I'm talking to at least 10 people in here that find out doing easy is easy for you. But God's getting ready to touch you and reset you today. That you're going to have a mind say, no, 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 no. Come on, practice with your neighbor. No, 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 that ain't right. Yeah. That's in other words, the mind that was in Christ, Brother Anthony Diary, who this is his favorite scripture, is a mind that is selfless. It's a mind that is formed in servitude. It's always asking, what can I do to help someone and not how they can help me? It is a mind that desires to obey God. It is a mind that is achieved, if you read the scripture, through life and through fasting. Paul says, but they that are after the Spirit, do mind the things of the Spirit. In other words, you want to love everybody. You want to get along and not be argumentative or annoying. You want, yes, to walk in joy. This year you made up your mind. I'm not letting folk drive me crazy. You made up your mind. You're going to strive to be a peacemaker. I'm not getting other folks' hell. If y'all mad at each other, that's on y'all. Stop calling my phone. Want me to referee what's going on between y'all. Y'all been fighting for years. Stay with that stuff over there. Touch your neighbor beside you and say, I'm going to be a peacemaker. You know why I want to be a peacemaker? Because the text says, so that we can be like Jesus. How many know that when you're like Jesus, you have a gentle spirit? You're not always up in people's face telling them you're going to punch them and slap them and cuss them and mistreat them. But when you're trying to be like Jesus, how many know he was a meek and humble lamb? The more they pulled hair out of his beard, the more he said, God bless you. Do I have any witness say, not only am I trying to be gentle, but in this season, I'm trying to be good. Do I have any witnesses out there that say, I want goodness and mercy following me all the days of my life? Do I have any witnesses out there to say, I'm not trying to be fast and
I'm not trying to be a number one star. All I really want to do, Mama Ann, is walk by faith. Do I have any witnesses out there to say, I'm walking by faith? While you're walking by faith, Hebrews 11 and 6 says it like this: they that walk by faith shall please God. I ain't trying to please you all the time. I'm trying to please God, because when I look back over my life, when people ran out of my life, He was there, Lady Samantha, all the time. Do I have any witnesses out there to say it's just right to try to be right with God? Lean over and grab your neighbor by the hand and say, neighbor, I'm leaving here with a new mind today. I'm leaving here with my mind reset. I'm leaving here with my mind rebooted. Somebody say yes. I said, somebody say yes. Paul said in the word, if my mind chase worldly things, he said, then death shall be my portion. He said, but if I chase after the Spirit, then I shall see life and peace. Lean over and lay your hand on your neighbor and say, neighbor, be careful what you're chasing, because it may turn around and start chasing you. Get your neighbor and tell them, neighbor, in 2020, walking right. If you get your mind right, you will start living right. If you get your mind right, you'll start giving right. And I want somebody to purpose in 2020. I want to be an example of Jesus Christ. And I want the Lord to help me get right. Lay your hand on as many people as you can. Touch everybody on your own. Say, it's my season of get right. It's my season of get right. Get right, get right. Get right, get right. Is there anybody here? You're not searching for double this year. You just want something different. You want different outcomes. You want different relationships. You want God to do a new thing in your life. You're not searching for money. But how many want to manage what you got? Touch your neighbor, tell them, I'm not searching for more. I'm searching for God to manage what I have. Do I have any witnesses out there and say, I'm not searching to be great, but I'm searching for God's grace? I wish I had a witness out there that would say, I want God's favor in 2020 like I've never had it before. I heard Matthew 6 say it like this: seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all other things will be added unto you. Grab your neighbor by the hand, shake it like you're going to shake it off, and say, neighbor, I'm only searching for the God of my salvation. And He promised me, if I seek after Him, He'll cause everything that I need to seek after me. Now somebody put a praise on. Blessings are getting ready to come and overtake you. Y'all didn't hear what I just said. While you're running after God, God's going to cause stuff to start running after you. If you get closer to God, other stuff will get closer to you. If you get wisdom, God will give you wealth. Somebody shout amen. I got to get out of here. But I need you all to jump up on your feet one last time and get ready. Get ready, get ready. Get ready, get ready. This is what I want you to do. I want you to get out of your seat. Go over to at least 12 people. Put your hand on their back and holler, reset. 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 Oh, Lord. God's getting ready to reset you. reset. When you get on the job, it's going to be reset. When you start doing your business and start working your business, somebody holler reset. Resetting your finances. Resetting your relationships. Resetting your body. Somebody holler reset. Resetting your marriage. Reset with your siblings. Reset with your children. Somebody holler reset. Anybody need a reset? God's still ready to reset. Reset your mind.
They would say, did you reset?
Reach across the aisle, leave no.
Let's take it back.